Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to a song, There Will Be Some Changes Made. It's a song sung by Mark Knopfler and Chet Atkins.
This is from the album Neck and Neck.
Neck and Neck.
Very nice name for the album, using the guitar as a reference point.
Yeah, I think it's about the guitar.
The necks of the guitar. Yeah. So I'm assuming this has got some good guitaring in it.
Yeah, both.
Good guitar work should be there.
Both artists have guitars in this one.
This is the first time Single Take on its reaction to this particular song, as well as these two set of people. We have reacted to Dire Straits, we have reacted to Mark Knopfler once before, solo.
Yeah.
Not these two gentlemen. It seems really interesting.
Yeah.
Can't wait to get started with this one. This is for our patron,
Kristen.
Thank you for all your feedback and all your encouragement.
Yes, Kristen.
And all the valuable information that helps us grow as a channel. Let's get started.
Nobody wants you when you just play guitar. There'll be some changes made tomorrow. There'll be some changes made.
Yeah, but Chet, you're never gonna get to play that rock and roll.
Why is that?
You're kind of country.
Oh,
it's a little bit old.
That hurts. But your money for nothing, and your chicks for free.
Groupie girls ain't what they're cracked up to be. Not all of them, anyway.
Well, I'd really like to find out for myself, don't you know? I've had a kind of quiet life down here on Music Row.
Oh, I know.
Well, man, what do you think?
Man, I don't know.
I really think that I can make the grade.
Daddy-o.
There'll be some changes made. I think I was sharp there.
Just play one.
Don't you know, cause like I said, I've had a sheltered life down here on Music Row.
Well, maybe so.
Well, what do you think, Mark?
I don't know.
I really think that I can make the grade. There'll be some changes. Now listen to this, I'm gonna play some.
Cut.
Mark Knopfler.
What about that one there?
Not all that bad.
They definitely get my respect.
Yeah.
Beautiful music. Beautiful music. This is real music.
This is real music.
Whenever you hear real music, you always respect it. And if you don't, if you overreact, if you give a fake reaction, if you go over the top with your critique, wow. Though I'm tempted to, but yeah, I'll never do that. I'll never do that.
Mm.
I know it works. Somehow on this platform, whenever I've given an overreaction, it somehow is accepted much more than when I give an honest reaction the remaining 99% of the time. And not that I want to be dishonest, it's just that it's over the top.
Mm-hmm.
So people considered it a fake reaction.
Mm-hmm.
And there were comments also mocking me and saying it's fake and you've heard it before. And you know, a lot of things like that. Yeah, this music deserves my respect. What about you, Kirti? What are your thoughts?
Mine as well. I enjoyed every bit of it. I enjoyed it thoroughly. You know, the only wish I had was, I wish I could, you know, be where they were both making this music. It would be fun. It would be fun watching them. I have 4 or 5 words only starting with C. For you, Kristen, because your name is with C. There was great chemistry. This was casual music. This was candid music. This was conversational. And that's how it becomes classic and cool.
It was cool, super cool.
So that's what I felt about it. Oh, wow, that chemistry, the play of words between them, exchange of words, and then guitar playing. Both of them were just...
And I don't need to be calculus to give my calculations on this one. It's a 10 on 10 performance.
Wow, yay.
A 10 on 10 song rather. It's not quite actually a performance.
Yeah.
But it sounds like that one, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Easygoing conversational style of...
Just like easygoing native outsiders.
Music. Easygoing native outsiders, just like us. Although at times we're not so easygoing for some reason.
Yeah.
The music makes us very
depressed.
But
this is easygoing. It makes you...
This makes us light. This makes us feel good, yeah.
Yeah.
Wonderful voices. Both of them have amazing voices. Wow, this is amazing. I think I've heard the other guy too, but I don't know where. Perhaps someone in the comments will definitely say what's his background or things like that. Mm-hmm. I initially thought it would be something from the 70s.
Okay.
But then
After Michael Jackson and Prince.
Not after, but yeah, after they
came. Definitely after they are in.
After
they
in, Prince and Michael Jackson.
Yeah, both because their references were made.
Both of whom are not with us today. Hmm. Great legends of the music industry on their own terms, on their own rights, and for their own kind of music and performances.
True.
No one can dance like Michael. He may wear vague makeup, but no one can dance like him.
People still dance.
Makeup or not, people can't dance like him. Yeah, I mean, and same goes with Prince. Phenomenal guitar work. I mean, if anyone has watched Prince, I mean, heard him, I have watched a few live performances of his too. Not at the concert, but at DVD and award shows.
Mm-hmm.
He is one of the best, was one of the best performers ever. Right. Coming to these guys, they are definitely a humorous duo. Lot of talent, obviously. Great vocals, great chemistry, as Kirti said. Everything about this was extraordinary. Is their take on the industry and what was going on probably at that time.
Yeah.
Possibly the early 80s, late 80s, I'm not sure. But their take on the industry, how it was, you could just couldn't make it with just a guitar. You know, you would have to have some other skills too. You may have to wear makeup, you may have to put on a uniform, school uniform, like some band member used to do.
Yeah.
You may have to put on makeup like rock band people do. Some of them wear masks and things like that. Look absolutely weird, but still pull it off and be proud of it too at the end of
sometimes
the day.
Sometimes it was uncomfortable I thought. Looking at them, I didn't think they were comfortable.
No, I'm not talking about Kiss. I'm talking about Slipknot here.
I'm talking about anyone.
Yeah, but anyway, this Kiss is cool. Kiss is always cool, has always been cool.
Yeah.
The fact is, you know, their music speaks for itself. They may wear makeup, they may look like clowns, they may look like horrible clowns. They may look like anything, but when the music starts, you know that they are incredibly talented. So this song is a funny, humorous take on the industry and maybe the changing times. Maybe the people's demands were changing. They wanted a bit more than just guitar solos and guitar work. They wanted
and pure music.
They wanted more lyrics, they wanted more vocals, they wanted more depth, and why not?
Or more drama.
Why not? Maybe more drama, maybe more marketing was required as MTV came onto the scene, as other channels came onto the scene, as more radio stations.
Yeah.
There were literally so many radio stations that cropped up in America as well as different parts of Asia, and perhaps more than 100, at least in Asia, and then maybe more than maybe hundreds in America, I'm not sure how many, playing different genres of music. So you just couldn't get just playing a guitar. I mean, there are people who do that still, and people do respect them and they have their huge fan followings. But apart from those few, I guess you do need to have a personality, you do need to have a way of marketing yourself. And this is what it is. It's also about other things, you know, just being candid about different things said, mentioned, Bible, summer Bible school.
This is from Bible school, one tune that he played.
Yeah, so a lot of things added in just to make it fun, I guess.
Yeah, it was fun.
At the end of the day, it works. It works. It's something different. It's something refreshing.
Yeah.
It does remind me of the great legends of the past, whether you talk about B.B. King, whether you talk about Ray Charles, whether you talk about Jerry Lee Lewis, whether you talk about Elvis Presley. They just didn't have a great sounding voice or a great way of singing things. They also had an act.
Okay.
It was a complete
act. It's called a package in the industry.
Yeah,
entertainment. Yeah, entertainment industry. Whether you are coming with a package or not.
Yeah, I mean, it also works, unfortunately, whether we like it or not. Just like the movie Cook Up a Storm, also MasterChef, reality shows for culinary skills or cookery, if you want to call it that.
Yeah,
obviously, the presentation has become so important.
A lot,
The way you present the meal matters so much more than how it tastes
and at the end of the day. Wholesome or nutritious it is.
In fact, you do know by the body language of the judges sometimes that actually the food doesn't taste good, but yes, they are giving that person the benefit of the doubt because it looks good. It looks good.
Presented.
In fact, you know, I know as a professional cook, I know for sure that some of the times those dishes are not supposed to be made that way. I know. But for some reason, just because they presented it well, it sells. So the same goes for many people. I mean, today's music industry does have a lot of these people, and I'm not sure if the musicians themselves are completely to blame. Obviously, a major role is played by the management, by the record label, by the channels on which they are, or modes of sales and marketing and other things which finally display their music or plays their music. I think a lot of people have a role to play in the state of affairs right now, even 30, 40 years ago. People say a lot has changed. The only thing that may have changed is the quality of music. Definitely there's a deterioration compared to the previous decades. But at the same time, there are new genres of music. There's new styles, there's new marketing techniques. Off and on, you get something altogether brilliant or a unique take on things. So yeah, I mean, everyone has their own take on things. And this is one such take. What are your thoughts, Kirti, very quickly? I know I took up a lot of time in this one.
I enjoyed this music. I loved both of them singing, talking to each other, having a great time together, fun time. And that could be, you know, just passed on to us as well. It was contagious. The fun that they were having was contagious. It was directly coming across to us. And more than the heads or anything else, the feet move on this song. You know, your feet keep going somewhere or the other. I enjoy songs which make my feet go here and there. You know, you totally are enjoying the music. That's when you're enjoying. The ironic thing is that about North America, about USA, in particular, we Indians are supposed to love spicy food. We are known in the world for eating spices because it's a land of lots of spices. That's what we have as a natural resource we are blessed with. And a lot of people came and they wanted spices, though they can't take it most of the times. But in America, people like spicy entertainment. If it is simple, if it is lean, if it is just, you know, wholesome and nutritious, it just won't do. It has to be spiced up. It has to be spicy. It has to have many elements. It has to have a lot of theatrics and drama.
Yeah, let's put it that way. The day of the peanut butter and jelly sandwiches are over.
As far
as the music industry is concerned, obviously.
Yeah.
So that's how it is.
And now it has gone to junk food. At the moment, it has gone to junk food.
But I think, Kirti, you're a little bit wrong. It's not only about America.
It's about the whole world. Yeah,
They are the leaders
They set the trend.
Yeah, they are leaders. They are pioneers.
They set
too.
The trend.
And we must respect that.
Yeah.
That is also important.
It is.
But at the same time, yeah, definitely there is a degradation, there's a deterioration, there's a downgrade of music, and people who have real talent obviously have to step up to the plate, and why not? Why not? I complain sometimes, or I talk about, you know, that our channel doesn't do so well on YouTube compared to those guys who have that.
Mm-hmm.
Who have those fake reactions and exaggerated reactions, and perhaps sit and smoke weed or do or drink something or pretend that they have smoked weed and drunk something.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm not one of those people, and neither is Kirti. She never has been.
I will be the last person. I might as well die.
Yeah, obviously we don't have those theatricals, although I have a certificate in acting for theatre, theatre and screen. But unfortunately, I don't stand a chance with those kind of guys, you know. So yeah, I'm not going to rehab, and I don't look like I've just come out of rehab. So yeah, I don't stand a chance for those people. This platform loves those people, and the people on this platform seem to love those kind of people. And why not? When you have 3 million plus people who are on drugs in America alone, so why not?
There will be some changes made. That's
definitely
what we must
all
say.
Those people must be loving those kind of reactors,
yeah,
who are on those kind of substances or seem to be. Let's end this. I think it's about it. I guess we've given our own take on it,
yeah.
And I'm proud.
We enjoyed it, yeah.
I'm proud of what I do, and I connect wholeheartedly with this song. I have great respect for real people, real musicians, and real reactors on this platform.
This is wholesome. Thanks for watching.